Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let's see all about SCR, which is nothing but silicon control rectifier. So this is a basic concept, guys. Guys, you can expect the direct question of a particular thing, guys. He'll be giving define SCR for 5 marks directly, and you need to define it. You need to draw the block diagram, its symbol and how it works and its applications, if possible, advantages and disadvantages also. Okay, so let us go through SCR first. So SCR is a silicon control rectifier, guys. It is also called as a semiconductor control rectifier. So basically silicon is a semiconductor, right? So semiconductor controlled rectifier, that's what I have just written. That's another name. Or we can also call it as triester. I think the spelling is wrong. So it is triester. Okay, triester we call it as. Okay, so SCR is a unidirectional semiconductor device. That means only current flows in one direction. Okay guys, so it is a unidirectional and the current flows only in one direction. So basically, further moving on, it has three terminals, guys, and four layers. So four semiconducting layers. So the four terminals are anode, gate, cathode. Anode, cathode, and in between we'll be having a gate. Okay, and the layers will be PNPN. Okay, the arrangement will be something like that. Okay guys, so now I hope everyone got a small idea on that. So further moving on to the block diagram will be like this. So this is a block in which PNPN is there, and anode will be at the top. On anode will be with P and cathode will be with N, and gate will be with P2, guys. From the cathode, here this is the first cathode semiconductor, right? For that next one we'll be having the gate. Okay guys, so now I hope everyone got a small idea. So the symbol of a silicon control rectifier is a diode with an gate, anode, cathode, and a gate. That's it guys, there is no confusion in this. Okay, so basically it can also be made using NPN and PNP transistor. So I hope everyone is now clear with transistors also. We have discussed them. So basically we can also make it using NPN and PNP. So if you arrange them in this way, such that these two are similar, these two are similar, so that at the end they are going to form a NPNP. That's it. So this is how we draw a SCR in terms of two transistors. Excuse me, that is nothing but PNP. Sorry, NPN and PNP. Okay, guys. Okay. So this is what I have just drawn here. So if you want to learn how I just drawn that, so that's really easy, guys. There is nothing confusion in that. So basically, I'll be drawing like this. This is my first transistor and this is my second transistor. Okay, so I'll be assuming this as PNP and this as, sorry, this as NPN and this as PNP. So in NPN it will be like this, and for PNP it will be like this. Okay, so I hope everyone knows that. So basically this is emitter, collector, and this will be our base. Similarly, collector, base, emitter. Okay guys, I hope everyone got a small idea. These representations you can learn it in the second unit, guys, BJT. You're gonna learn everything regarding this. So basically we'll be assuming this as emitter, base, collector, right? Okay, now here, collector, base, emitter. So basically the first, let us assume this as Q1 and this as Q2. So this is our Q1 and this is our Q2. So Q1's B is connected to Q2's C. So I'll be connecting these two. Similarly, Q1's C is connected to Q2B. So, okay, these two I'll be connecting. So that's how I form the diagram of a SCR using two different transistors. Okay guys, so now I hope everyone is now 100% clear guys, because I have explained you in detail by just drawing it in front of you. Okay, so now let us go through the working of this. So we observe three different modes guys. Okay, so we'll be going one after the other so that will be clear for you. So basically the reverse blocking mode. First let us go through reverse blocking mode. So basically reverse. So from the word itself we can say that it is connected in the reverse bias. Okay, so it occurs when SCR is in reverse bias condition. Yeah, that's what I have just written. So I have just drawn a diagram like this guys, in reverse connection. There is nothing but reverse bias. Okay, so once we give it a reverse bias, so this will be our anode and this will be our cathode, right? So our four layers, right? PN. So 1 1 2 2. So P1 N1 P2 N2, so that it will be clear for you while I am explaining. So in between P1 and N1 we are having junction, one junction. So I'll be giving it as J1. And further moving on, in between N1 and P2 we are having one more junction, that is J2. In between P2 and N2 we are having one more junction, that is J3. So for N layers we will be having N-1 junctions. You can even remember like this, or you can just follow my method to find it guys, it's really easy. So basically now you observe and say me that which junctions are going to be in forward bias and which junctions are going to be in reverse bias. So basically we'll be assuming these two first. So negative is given to positive and positive is given to negative. So when you consider a single junction, assume that there is no part like this. So now this is directly connected to N. So P2N and minus to P, this is going to be reverse bias. So J1 is in reverse bias. Similarly, try for J2. So negative to N, P2 positive. So J2 is in forward bias. Similarly, P2N2. So negative to P, positive to N. That also comes under reverse bias. So J1, J3 are in reverse bias. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on reverse blocking mode. So now let us go through forward blocking mode. Okay, so now I hope everyone is now clear that how we are going to do this. So it occurs when SCR is in forward bias condition. Yeah, and anode is positive, cathode is negative. Fine. And J1 and J3 are in forward bias and J2 is in reverse bias. So let's verify it. I have just drawn it on the back page guys. Okay, so if we give positive and if we consider J1 first, so positive to P and N2 negative to N. So J1 forward bias, J2 is in reverse bias. Fine. J3 forward bias. So if you want you can verify it guys. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So let us go through the VI characteristics graph guys. Okay, so basically this is 100% similar for reverse bias and forward bias. You may ask me why. So basically in forward bias we are having two junctions in forward and one junction in reverse. In reverse bias we are having two junctions in reverse bias and one junction in forward bias. So there is no much change guys. So in both the directions we'll be having only a slight amount of current guys. So for increase in voltage we gonna get very 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 low amount of current. Okay, so now we are done with two conditions, right? So our third condition is forward conduction mode. Okay, so I think everyone is now clear with the diagram of SCR. It is like this, right? So here there is a particular gate. So we applied for these two up to now. So now this forward conduction mode is all about that gate terminal. So basically applying more positive voltage at anode and cathode will be a condition, and by passing positive charges through the gate, that will be our second condition. Okay guys, so now let us go through one after the other so that will be 100% clear for you. Okay, Basically, in these two cases, we will be using SCR mainly. Got it? Okay. So let us go through it. If we apply, let us go through the first one. If we apply more amount of voltage, then J2 breakdown voltage decreases and a current will be produced huge. So if we apply more voltage in reverse or positive forward bias, okay, so let us assume that as forward bias. So in forward bias, I got two junctions that are J1 and J3 as forward. So if I rapidly increase this, these two junctions will vanish, as we all know that. And J2 depletion region should increase. But if you increase it really rapidly, you mean if you increase from 0 to 100 within one shift. So then there will be a huge current produced, guys. So if you just try to draw a graph for that, for voltage versus current will be something like this. It's going to be a huge increase at a particular snap. Okay. So further moving on now, let us go to the second condition by passing positive charge through the gate. Okay. So I have just drawn the circuit and I have told you that P will be our gate. So this is our gate. So we'll be applying the forward bias for that. So P to P, N to N. So now if you observe this clearly, so assume this as two-step diagram, guys. So assume that these parts are not there. So basically this PN type and this battery is not there. So P to P and N to N, right? So this is going to be under forward bias. Similarly, close these both. Now try P to P, N to N. So that is going to be a forward bias. So in this situation also, we are going to get a huge amount of current. Okay, guys. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So if you increase the current rapidly, guys, even if you increase the current of voltage, sorry, that's not current, guys, that's voltage of G rapidly, and you just removed that G. So if I increase the G, it is conducting really well and properly. So if I remove that G, up to some span of time, it's going to conduct properly, guys. That is up to where means that is the word comes latching current. Up to it reaches the latching current. So latching current is the minimum current required for SCR to be a conducting state. So until it reaches the latching current, it's going to conduct properly. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So there are a lots and lots of applications for this, guys. I am getting a list when I'm searching for these applications. So I wrote few of them. So power switching circuits, zero voltage switching circuits, over voltage protection circuits, control rectifier, inverters, battery charging regulators, computer logic circuits. So I'll be remembering these things, guys. That's it. Okay. So now I hope everyone is now 100% clear with SCR, silicon control rectifier. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through TRIAC, TRIAC. Okay, guys. Let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.